Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and hi, I am Yushafika binti Muhammad Yazid and for this company analysis, I have chosen Hong Leong Bank Berhad. Being one of the largest banking company in the finance sector in Malaysia, Hong Leong Bank Berhad is listed among top 50 companies based on market capitalization in Bursa Malaysia. It's also awarded as best SME bank in Malaysia in 2020. Now, Hong Leong Bank Berhad already widened their business to Singapore, Hong Kong, Vietnam, Cambodia, and also China. So the strategy that I have been applied in this Hong Leong Bank company analysis is Fibonacci technique. I have been analyzed between the time period of early January 2021 until the end of May 2021, which constitute as 5 months in the total. And the time frame that was used for this process is 1 hour. I was looking at the points in which the price hit the Fibonacci line, such as at 0.236, 0.382, and also the others. Some of the golden ratios that I've been looking for are 0.382, 0.5, 0.618. First, we analyze the current trend of the chart to determine what Fibonacci strategy should be applied, whether it is Fibonacci extension or whether it's Fibonacci retracement. So the current trend that the Hong Leong Bank Berhad shows is uptrend. Thus, I apply Fibonacci extension for this analyzation process. So for the finding, I could say the frequency of the Fibonacci to be appear on Hong Leong Bank chart is quite high, considering that there are about 8 times in which the price falls or hit exactly at the Fibonacci lines, and there are also a few times in which the price falls or hits just a little below or just a little higher than the Fibonacci lines. And the winning rate is also high, considering that majority of them are consistent with Fibonacci theory in which it acts as support and resistance. For example, there are prices that even surpassing a strong Fibonacci resistance line, which resulting in uptrend movements. One of the examples that could be seen is during the 5th March, which the price fall on Fibonacci lines and it's bounced back higher until it's surpassing a strong resistance line 0.236. This indicates that the Fibonacci line acts as a support. Moreover, there are also a sideways trend during the 24th March until 7th April, here under the Fibonacci lines 2.618, which indicate that the Fibonacci lines act as a strong resistance. However, there are a few times that the price fell on Fibonacci lines does not reflect and follow the Fibonacci theory. In fact, the price went lower and lower until it formed a continuous downtrend. As we can see here, for example, the price in 13 April, the price hit or falls on Fibonacci lines at 1.618, but it does not bounce back as what the Fibonacci theory tells us. Instead, it goes lower and lower. In conclusion, Fibonacci strategy really helps in our trading strategy as it gives prediction on support and resistance. As we know these two spots, we could plan our trading whether we want to buy, to hold or to sell. We could also combine the Fibonacci strategy with other indicator. And looking at the Hong Leong Bank Berhad graph, even though that the Fibonacci strategy may work for only a few hours or a few days, and some of them are not following that Fibonacci theory, it is really, really helpful to apply and to be aware of Fibonacci as the indicator of the support and resistance. And it's already proven a few times in this analyzation regarding the ease and frequency in which it hits about 8 times the Fibonacci lines, and some majority of them really act as support and resistance at what such as what the Fibonacci theory have been told to us. So that's all from me. Thank you.